that side, there is no x4, so the coefficient is 0, of course. The cube, it's c on the left side, and on the right side, there is no c. I mean, there is no x cubed, so it's 0. And then the 2a plus 2b, or plus b plus d, is for the x squared, and there is no x squared on the right side, on the left side, sorry. And finally, c plus e is for the x, but there is no x on the left side. And the constant is a, and here the constant is 1. And remember, the number of unknowns will tell you how many equations you have. And we had 5 of them, so we have 5 equations.
A equals 1, nice.
Yeah, and this is nice because if a equals 1, we know that what b is.
Negative 1.
Yeah, so b equals negative 1.
But we know what a and b is, and we know what d is.
If c equals 0, we know what e is.
0.
E equals 0. Okay. We know a and b. So d equals negative 2a minus b. Negative 2a would be negative 2 minus a minus 1 would be plus 1. So b, b equals negative 1. So we have all of them 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Do you mind explaining how you got, like, a plus b equals 0, or c equals 0,
okay.
2a plus b plus d equals 0. I don't know where those numbers can come from.
These are two polynomials. Okay. And polynomials, you know, degree 4 here, and degree 0. We said that two polynomials are equal if their respective coefficients are the same.
So, basically.
Here there is no x, so that's a 0x. There is no x squared. There is no x cubed. And there is no x4. They don't, because their coefficient is 0, that's why they disappear. So if I equate the two, then I equate this one and that one. These two must be the same for the two polynomials to be the same. And then the x cubed here has a coefficient of 0, then this one has a coefficient of 0 also. And then go down the line, 0 for x, 0 for x squared. This is 0 and this is 0. And finally, you see the constant is 1. That's the constant term.
Oh, okay.
And over there, the constant term is a. So that's how you equate to get your system of equations. That's why I say always put them in descending orders. Okay. So then you look at highest power here. Well, where is the highest power? Right here also. Well, it's not existing. So coefficient is 0. That's why it's 4. If this coefficient was 4, for example, then you would have a plus b equals 4. So now, what is the decomposition then of that, what is it, of this one right here? So A we know is 1, this is 1 over x. B is equal to negative 1, so I put a negative x. And C equals 0, so that's x over x squared plus 1. And then which one is 0, the D or the E? The E is 0, but D is minus 1, so we have